Hi students, welcome to the next session of competitive level 1 we are solving. So we solved up to 47th question I think. See the next 48th question, that is graph they gave. A ball is dropped vertically from a height d above the ground. It hits the ground and bounces up vertically to a height d by 2. Neglecting the subsequent motion and air resistance, its velocity v varies with height above the ground as. They have given one graph there, isn't it? Question number 48. So they gave a ball is dropped from some height d. This height h is equal to d ray. Whenever it is coming downwards, it is hitting the ground. After hitting the ground, it is rising up to half of the height. Half of the height means it will rise here, but for our convenience I am showing. So what is this height now? D by 2. So they are asking what is the velocity and distance. Velocity and distance. Which equation we are going to use? V square minus u square equal to 2ax. V square. U value a drop of the 0. So v square minus u square equal to 2gh. This is value 2gd. So then v is directly proportional, or v is equal to root 2gd. So v is directly proportional to d power half, or v is equal to root 2gd power 1 by 2. So this equation is parabola equation. Therefore, whenever at height h is equal to d, what is its velocity? 0. So they have given first option. I am drawing. They gave one graph like this. Okay. So this is velocity, distance. First we are seeing this. Seeing this option. So at distance d, this axis is giving distance. This axis is giving velocity. At some distance, what is its velocity? 0. At this distance, height, what is its velocity? 0. If distance is going to decrease, distance is going to become decreasing. After coming here, what is the distance means? Here 0. But it is having some velocity. That is nothing but root 2gh. So initially at some height, distance, velocity is 0. Whenever distance is going to become 0, velocity is going to get. It is coming downwards, therefore velocity value will become negative here. Why? Because it is coming downwards. Upwards we will take positive. Therefore, it is showing negative velocity here. Why we have drawn like this parabola shape means? Because we got in the equation y is equal to kx square. Y is equal to kx square shape. Therefore, we have drawn parabola shape. Okay? Now, after this, it is rising. How much height it is rising? Half of the distance. So, exactly this is half means, we will assume, this is d by 2 means. So, now here velocity is there. Which velocity? Velocity is upwards. Therefore, velocity is upwards means positive value. Therefore, it is coming here. Again, velocity after reaching, it is reaching d by 2. It is reaching d by 2. This is d means exactly half of this one, d by 2. So, whenever it is d by 2, its velocity is going to become 0. Why? Because it is reaching only d by 2. Okay, therefore, which graph is correct? Means first graph only correct. Therefore, option 1 is the correct one. Okay, this is theoretical question, and in mathematics you will get this nature, parabola nature. Till then, so it will be a little bit difficult to understand you people. But where velocity is 0, where height is 0, means distance is 0, means the displacement is going to become 0. If it, by seeing that part, we can understand. So if there is no parabola equation, but parabola equation you will be getting in your mathematics. Okay, that. Next is the 49th question. So the position x of a particle with respect to time is given by x is equal to alpha t minus beta t square minus theta t cube. The ratio of velocity at t equal to 2 seconds and average velocity during the time interval t is equal to 0 to t equal to 2 seconds. The ratio of velocity at time is equal to 2 seconds to at time 0 to 2 seconds. Here what is the velocity. Between time 0 to 2 seconds, what is the average velocity? They are asking the ratio between V and VR. How will you get the angles? They get displacement. Then how will you get velocity? We have to differentiate this equation. V is equal to dx by dt. Okay. Then d by dt of what is x value? Alpha d minus beta t square minus theta t cube. Differentiate. So I already told you explain detail. I am going to write it direct step. If you want me, you can keep the pause the video and you can try by expanding one by one, you will be getting. Okay. So alpha is constant, dp by dt value 1 minus 2 beta t minus 3 theta t square. So I already did this one so many times. Now velocity at 2 seconds, first we are time. Velocity at time 2 seconds. So alpha, in this t there is no t, therefore alpha minus 2 beta, t value how much? 2 minus 3 beta, t value how much? 2 square. Okay, so alpha minus this one, 2 into 2, 4, therefore alpha minus 4 beta minus, so 3 into 4, 4 3 is 12. Well, theta, isn't it? This is velocity at 2 seconds. Velocity at 2 seconds. Now we have to find average velocity between time 0 to 2 seconds. Average velocity formula. What is the formula? X2 minus X1 by T2 minus T1. Total displacement by total time. So what is X2? X2 at time 2 seconds. What is x formula here? Alpha t minus beta t square minus theta t. Substitute t value 2. Therefore, 2 alpha minus t value 2. 2 square into beta minus 4 beta minus 2 cube into theta. 2 cube means 8 theta. This is final position at t is equal to 2 seconds. Now, x1. X1 means t1 value how much? This is t2 minus t1. Initial time how much is 0. Therefore, alpha theta. Sorry, alpha t. T value 0. T value 0. T value 0. Therefore, you will get final position 0. Therefore, substitute. So, v average is equal to x2 value 2 alpha minus 4 beta 8 theta minus x1 value 0 divided by t2 minus t1 2 minus 0. So v average is equal to, so 2 is common from here, alpha minus 2 beta minus 4 theta is divided by 2. This 2 will be cancelled. Alpha minus 2 beta minus 4 theta. This is average velocity. They are asking ratio between velocity at 2 seconds and average velocity. Velocity at 2 seconds formula. So what you got here? Alpha minus 4 beta minus 12 theta is divided by alpha minus 2 beta minus 4 theta. So that is the correct answer. So but you didn't get the option. So, but that is the correct answer for you. Okay. So, some minus, plus, negative, they didn't do properly. So, correct option is not there. But answer is that. Okay. See the next question. Question number 50. If velocity of a particle is given by V is equal to alpha plus beta x square, then acceleration is given by, they are asking acceleration. We got one formula. A is equal to V into dv by dx, because this is in terms of x, as this formula you can do. A is equal to dv by dt. So dv by dx into dx by dt. So this dv by dx we have written like this. Dx by dt we can write as V into dv by dx. This is the acceleration formula. If you forgot, means Okay, how we got this formula? Now we already came to know v. Now we should find dv by dx. Now this equation with respect to x we have to differentiate. So dv by dx is equal to d by dx of alpha plus beta x squared. So with respect to x, this is constant. Therefore 0 plus 2 beta x. 2 beta x here. So this value you can substitute. So a is equal to v into dv by dx. V value alpha plus beta x square. Dv by dx value 2 beta x. So you can expand, you will be getting answer. So still they give the expand this much. 2 alpha beta x plus 2 beta into beta beta square. X into x square x cube. 2 alpha beta x plus 2 beta square x cube. Which is the correct option? Option 2 is the correct answer. Next up, question number 51. The relation between velocity and displacement is given by v is equal to 20 plus 30x over power 1 by 2 meter per second. Then acceleration is given by v is equal to 20 plus 30x whole power 1 by 2. This is question number 51. What's on it? 51. So what they are asking to calculate? Then acceleration is given by. Acceleration is given by means again same model. A is equal to v into dv by dx. Same model, but why I am solving means here x squared times the area whole power 1 by 2 there. At the time, how we should do? Because this model we did solve. First we have to find dv by dx. So d by dx of 20 plus 30x whole power 1 by 2. Okay, so whenever we are solving, previously we wrote here derivative of this alpha constant, but here whole power 1 by 2. This 20 is also there in the root. From this whole power 1 by 2, this 20 also will come. Therefore, whenever we are differentiating, we will write like this. So m into half into 20 plus 30x n minus 1. Again, you should differentiate this one. At the time, derivative of 20 is going to become 0. Derivative of this one is going to become 30. Okay, so this one also, they will start derivatives in mathematics. At the time, directly you will write this term. Okay, you will understand at the time. But how we are writing now means, again by using same form. If you didn't understand now means, after completion of mathematics, you can definitely understand this. Now, 15 into 20 plus 30x whole power minus 1 by 2. This is dv by dx. Dv by dx value we got. Now we should find a. How we will find a? A is equal to v into dv by dx. V value 20 plus 30x whole power by 2. Dv by dx value 15 into 20 plus 30x whole power minus 1. So this one will be same. 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2. How much you get? 0. Anything power 0 is equal to 1. Therefore, in place of these two terms, you will get 1. Now, what is the answer? 15. So, 15 meter per second square. So, you might not have understood this one, but this one you will understand after completion of mathematics only. Now, we can't solve anything other than this. Okay. Next up. Question number 52. A particle is moving in a straight line and displacement x in terms of t is given. 12t minus 60 square. 12t minus 60 square plus t cube. Plus t cube. Isn't it? Plus t cube they give. So this is the equation, displacement equation there. Now what they are asking? Acceleration of the particle when its velocity is 0. Already we did so many times this one. Acceleration is how much? Whenever velocity is going to become 0. So velocity 0 means here they give displacement. Therefore differentiate this one. So v is equal to dx by dt. So d by dt of 12b minus 16 square plus t cube. So after differentiating, this one 12 minus 12t plus 3t square. Directly I am writing. Okay, now when velocity is 0, means what we have to do? This velocity we have to equate for 0. At the time, how you will get? We will see. Velocity 0 means 12 minus 12t plus 3t square is going to become 0. So this is quadratic equation. You can take common 3. So 3 common means t square minus 4t plus 4 is going to become 0. Isn't it? 4 3s are 12. 4 3s are 12. So this 12 I wrote here minus 4t. I have written minus 12 plus 40. 3 I took common. This 0 by 3 will become 0. So this is again quadratic equation. So quadratic equation means 2 2s are 4, therefore t square minus 2t plus 4. So t is common, t minus 2, minus 2 is common, t minus 2. Therefore t minus 2, so t minus 2, this is plus 2. So minus 2 common, therefore t minus, therefore how much you got? T is equal to 2 seconds. So velocity is 0 after 2 seconds. Now when velocity is 0, they are asking acceleration. But acceleration equation still we didn't find. First we have to find acceleration. How we will find acceleration? A is equal to dv by dt. So d by dt, what is the velocity equation we got? This is the velocity equation. So 12 minus 12t plus 3t square. Derivative constant 0 minus 12 plus 60. This is A. This acceleration they are asking whenever time t is equal to 2 seconds. How we came to know after 2 seconds means because after 2 seconds its velocity is going to become 0. They are asking acceleration when velocity is going to become 0. Velocity is 0 after 2 seconds. Therefore we are substituting here 2 minus 12 plus 6 into 2. Therefore minus 12 plus 2. That is nothing but acceleration is nothing but 0 you got. Okay, 50 second one is first option. Next say 53. The displacement of a particle x in terms of time is given by t minus x equal to t minus 2 whole power minus 2. X is equal to t minus 2 whole power minus 2. Then acceleration of particle is proportional. Acceleration there are. The acceleration like a displacement means we have to differentiate two times. So then v is equal to dx by dt. D by dt of x t minus 2 whole power minus 2. Again, this one you have to take it as x. Okay. So whenever you differentiate this one, whole power minus 2 is there. Minus 2 t minus 2 whole power minus 2 minus 1. Derivative of x power f. N into x power n minus 1 into dx. Dx means this one. So derivative of time is 1. Derivative of constant is 0. I told you already. The same model, this one also. What we got now? Velocity v is equal to minus 2 t minus 2 whole power minus 2. This is velocity. You should find acceleration. Acceleration means a is equal to so dv by dt. So d by dt of v value. So minus 2 into t power minus 2 whole power minus 2. This minus 2 you can write outside. So d by dt of t minus 2 whole power minus 3. Again this one also same like this only. Now here minus 3 is there. Therefore minus 3 into x power n minus 1. Minus 3 minus 1. Therefore minus 3 t minus 2 minus 3 minus 1. Again derivative of this one is 1. So therefore minus into minus plus 6 is equal to 6 t minus 2 whole power minus 4. But in options they gave x, x square, x cube, x power something there. So how we will write this one in terms of x? Because already x is nothing but how much? T minus 2 whole power minus 2. This one minus 4 can be written as like this. Once you can check. So 6 t minus 2 whole power minus 2 whole square. Minus 2 into 2 how much? Minus 4. This t minus 2 whole power minus 2 can be written as x. Therefore a is equal to 6. In place of this x whole square square. Therefore, A is directly proportional to 6 constant, therefore x square. Therefore, which is the option? Option 2 is the correct answer. Okay, so even 54 also same order, you can try it as homework. Same like this, you have to differentiate two times. Try to do. Next are 55. So 55 onwards, we are applying integration. The acceleration of the particle, they gave a is equal to 3t square only. And motion starts from rest at origin. The velocity and displacement of the particle will be. So it is starting from origin. They are asking velocity and displacement. Up to now we did differentiation. Now onwards you will do integration. Integration in mathematics you will be getting in your second period. But presently we are applying basics here. This is little bit easy only. So A is equal to, we came to know, dv by dt. Because A we wrote so many times. Rate of change of velocity. dv is equal to 3t square dt. So we want velocity and displacement. If we integrate this one, integration on both sides. Integral dv is equal to integral 3t square dt. So we wrote formulas. Integral dx is equal to x. Integral x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Between the limits also we wrote. I gave these two formulas, three formulas for you. Now we are going to apply these two formulas for this problem. Integral dx is x means integral dv value v. So x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. X power n dx. This 3 is constant. Write it outside. E square dt. In place of x, a t is there. In place of n, a 2 is there. Therefore, apply this formula. V is equal to 3 into x power n plus 1. Therefore, t power 2 plus 1. Because in place of x, t is there. In place of n, 2 is there. By 2 plus 1. So, 3 into t cube by 3. Then velocity is equal to t cube. You got velocity, they are asking displacement, velocity and displacement. Velocity first one will be there. Velocity first one means t cube you got. Therefore, option 2 is correct. But still, we have to find displacement. Because option already we got. But how to do displacement we will see. V is nothing but. Now we got V. V is nothing but dx by dt. Dx by dt is nothing but t cube. Then dx is equal to t cube dt. So again you will get now, if you integrate, you will get displacement. Therefore, integration on both sides. Integral dq, dt. Integral dx. Yes, this is the displacement. Integral tq, this formula you can apply. X power n dx. T cube dt. So t dt. In place of n, 3 is there. This formula if you wrote means t power 3 plus 1 by 3 plus 1. That is nothing but t power 4 by 4. So without solving only you can take second option because velocity t cube they give only in one option, that is option 2. Next are 56. 56 also same order. The acceleration of particle they give, if initial velocity of particle is 0, then its velocity at t is equal to 2 seconds they ask. A is equal to, what they give? A is equal to A naught plus, A is equal to A naught plus 2 alpha t plus 3 beta t square. 2 alpha t plus 3 beta t square. Then what they are asking to find? They are asking to find velocity of particle is 0. Initial velocity is 0. Then its velocity at 2 seconds will be. Velocity at 2 seconds. So what is the velocity at 2 seconds then? After 2 seconds. Now A, how we will write A is equal to dv by dt. Therefore we have to differentiate, integrate this one. dv by dt is equal to how much here? A0 plus 2 alpha t plus 3 beta t square. Then dv is equal to A0 plus 2 alpha t plus 3 beta t square into dv. So this dt will be multiplied for all quantities. Now we want velocity. What we should do? dv means we have to do integration. Integration on both sides. Integral dv is equal to integral a0 dt plus integral 2 alpha t dt plus integral 3 beta t square dt. Because I am expanding first term. Integral dx is x. Therefore, integral dv is v. So a0 is constant. a naught integral dt plus 2 alpha integral t dt plus 3 beta integral t square dt. So apply this formula for all terms and v is equal to a naught integral dx is x integral dt is t plus 2 alpha t power 1 is there. Therefore t power 1 plus 1 t power 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 plus 3 beta t power 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1. Okay. Now v is equal to a naught t plus 2 alpha t square by 2 plus 3 beta t cube by 3. So 3, 3 will be cancelled. 2, 2 will be cancelled. And what is the last equation you got? A naught t plus alpha t square plus beta t cube. So they are asking velocity at time t is equal to 2 seconds. Now substitute. In place of t, 2 you can substitute. Then 2 a naught t square, 2 square. 2 square means 4. 4 alpha t cube, 2 cube, 8 beta. 2 a naught 4 alpha plus 8 beta. That is the final answer. 2 a naught plus 4 alpha plus 8 beta. So that is there in which option? 2 a naught plus 4 alpha plus 8 beta. That is in second option. Okay. See the next question. 57. A particle is moving in a straight line with acceleration a is equal to alpha t square. Alpha t square. A particle starts from rest. Rest means initial velocity 0 and at time t equal to 0. The displacement of the particle in terms of t. The displacement of particle in terms of t. So they are asking displacement is changing from s to beta. Okay. So then how will you solve this one? Again they give a. They are asking displacement. Therefore a is equal to, we will write dv by dt is equal to alpha t square. dv is equal to alpha t square dv. So integration of both sides. Integration of both sides means integral dv is equal to integral alpha t square dt. Integral dv b. Again I am not writing, directly I am writing alpha t cube by 3. So v is equal to alpha t cube by. So this is the formula you got for velocity. Now if you write velocity equal to dx by dt, rate of change of displacement, that is nothing but dx by dt is equal to alpha t cube by 3. Then dx is equal to alpha t cube by 3 dt. Okay. So this one again we should do integration. Integral dx. Integral alpha t cube by 3 dt. So integral dx is x. Alpha by 3 is constant. T power 4 by 4. Then alpha t power 4 by 12. But this is changing from. Okay, this displacement is changing from where to where? Dx is changing from s to beta. So beta to s. I get between the limits. Integral dx between the limits a to b is nothing but x between the limits a to b, that is nothing but b minus a, upper limit, lower limit. This one also you will be getting mathematics second to you. So now distance is changing from s to beta, that is nothing but beta to s. Therefore beta to s. So s minus beta. Therefore s is equal to beta plus alpha t power 4 by 12. So that is the correct option. Which option now? So beta plus alpha t power 4, alpha t power 4 by 12. Okay, I think there is no option. Option 3 is correct. Okay, next 58, 59, 60, 61. 60 you can solve, but 61 all these are related to integration and more formulas you will be coming to know, but those formulas you don't know now. Integral 1 by x dx and log x and the e power x, those formulas you don't know. Therefore if I solve also you can't understand. Therefore we are not doing those problems. 60 you can do same model, same like this only you can solve 60th problem. You will be getting answer. We have to differentiate only one time, means integration on one time. Next question number 62 you can see. There they gave four graphs. Which of the following curve
does not represent the motion in one dimension. Does not represent the motion in one dimension. So they are asking, does not, which graph does not represent the motion in one dimension? One dimension means object is moving in a straight line motion. Okay, it should not come backwards. Okay, one dimension. They are asking which does not represent the one dimension. Means remaining all representing one dimension. Only one is not representing one dimension. See here, at time t is equal to zero, velocity is increasing. This graph, isn't it? So velocity is coming here again. After some time, velocity is zero. Therefore, is it one dimension? Means one dimension. See this one. So this is velocity time graph. All are velocity time graph. If you have taken one point that is here, at this point you will be having two different velocities. This is one velocity, this is one velocity. At one point an object will not have two different velocities. If it is having means, then it is called, which is not representing 1D. So this is also 1D, this is also 1D. Therefore correct option is this one. And this graph is also not representing one dimensional motion, because at one time it is having two different velocities. Okay. So see the next question, question number 63. They gave one graph, displacement time graph. Displacement time graph they gave. See the carefully graph, already we did this type of model. They are asking, consider the following displacement time graph for two particles A and B. They gave in options VA by VB, velocity of A by velocity of B ratio they are asking. In question they didn't ask anything. Depending on the options we will be knowing that they are asking VA by VB. So slope of this displacement time graph gives velocity. Slope of this one is tan theta, tan 30. But this angle they gave with y axis, you should take with x axis. This angle we want. This angle 30 means, what is this angle now? Total angle how much? This is 90. Therefore this is 30 means 90 minus 30. That is nothing but this angle. This total angle is equal to 60. Therefore velocity ratio tan theta A by tan theta B. Therefore tan 30 by tan 60. In mathematics already they gave this value, sin 30, cos 30, tan 30, tan 60. What is tan 30 value? 1 by root 3 by root 3. That is nothing but 1 by 3. 1 by 3 means 1 is 2, 3. Next up, question number 64, that is 3D question. So they give two graphs for two particles along x axis. We can say that both particles are having a uniform accelerated motion. So that is not correct. Both are particles having uniformly retarded motion, that is also correct. Not correct. Particle 1 is having uniformly accelerated motion and 2 is having uniformly retarded motion. Okay, that is correct. Uniformly accelerated displacement time graph, already we got like this. This is uniformly accelerated. So this is uniformly retarded. Retarded means with negative acceleration, that is called deceleration. Next, question number 65, last one in this. The displacement of a particle in time interval t is equal to 10 seconds to t is equal to 25 seconds. Okay. So they are asking there, the displacement of a particle in time interval 10 to 25 seconds. 10 to 25 means from here to here they are asking. What is the displacement graph? This is which graph? Velocity time graph. So velocity time graph means to get displacement, what we have to find? We have to find area. Area under velocity time graph gives. What it gives? Area under velocity time graph gives displacement. Area under acceleration time graph gives velocity or changing velocity. Slope of displacement time gives velocity. Slope of velocity time gives acceleration. Already this one we have been discussing fifth or sixth time, but you should remember this. Now this is velocity time graph, therefore we should find area. If you find total area, you will get total displacement from 0 to 25. But they are asking displacement from 10 to 25. That will be 10 seconds to 25. Means you have to find this area A1 and we have to find this area A2. So A1 is in the shape of which one? Trapezium. This is in the shape of trapezium. Area of trapezium formula of height into A plus B. This is area of trapezium formula. Correct only. So half height means this is A, this is B. This is nothing but height. 10 to 15 means difference how much?
that is nothing but 5.
This is a height how much?
This is a 10 plus
b height how much?
This is b, that is nothing but 30. So 5 by 2 into 40, 30 plus 10. So 1 so 5 into so a1 is 100 by 1.
This area by 1. Now we have to find this area. So this area is nothing but which shape? This one
area of triangle.
What is area of triangle formula?
Of base into
base value is this one.
This is base
of base value 20, 50 into 20. So this distance how much now? 25 minus 15. How much? 10. Okay.
Of base into height.
Again height means this one. That is nothing but 30. So this one will be cancelled. 5 times 5 that is 150. Total area how much? 100 plus 150. That is nothing but 250.
A is equal to 250 meters.
Which option now? Option 3. Okay. So this one we calculated between 10 to 25 because they asked the distance between or displacement between 10 to 25. If they ask what is the distance in 25 seconds, 0 to 25 seconds means this total area we should find. At the time this area and this area also we are going to find. So we solved level 1 almost 60 bits by without doing some bits are there because integration model. And we have to solve level 2 you have to solve and test your knowledge questions also you are doing. Like this, if this shortcut we have taken, we will do 1000, 2000, 3000, 10,000 problems we will solve. But in final exam you may get 1 or 2 questions only. So you should be in a position to solve those questions. This is only practice for you people. So you can practice remaining questions. So there is no end of mostly in a straight line lesson. But we have to stop somewhere. Therefore, we are going to stop here. So next video onwards, you will be getting next PU lesson. So next another sir will be coming. And they will be starting next lesson for you people. Till then, so we will see in our next PU topic. Okay.